My name is Moji Salamu Adamaja, and you know, whenever I see these books, you know it's time for a book review on Coda TV. Today we'll be talking about a book, and I have a co-host with me here. I want you to give the introduction of the book.
The title of the book we're reviewing today is The Richest Man in Babylon by Samuel George Clarkson.
Okay, the book was written in 1926. Yeah. Hey, we're in 2019. Can we do some mathematics here?
Like, it's like way back.
That is The Richest Man in Babylon. This book talks about finances. If you really want to have some very good sense in finance, you need that book. Everybody needs to read that book. I'm sure you've read the book.
Yes, I have.
Girlfriend, tell me. How was it?
It was an interesting read. Trust me, I really enjoyed every page of it. It was so interesting.
Do you have any favorites?
Well, I'll say the first story that has to do with Bansi, when he was seeking for wealth and all that, and how they went to Akkad to get the wealth.
Now, let me tell you something. That Akkad is the richest man in Babylon.
Exactly.
So I think Akkad is the main guy.
Yeah.
Akkad is the richest man in Babylon. Yes, exactly. Continue, please.
Okay, so Bansi was the one that started the story, and he was a chariot maker. He made the best chariots, like in the whole of Babylon. He made chariots for kings and all that. Then he got to a day, he got so tired. And
because, I want to enter.
Exactly.
Because he's still broke. That's it. You know, so many people are working. Plenty, we are hustling and working hard, but people are still broke.
Exactly.
Now, if you want to get a solution to that, you know, because I want you to read that book. That book is everything. Let's continue.
Okay, so he got so broke to the extent that he told his friend, lend me some money. And that one was like, I don't have any money to lend you. Where do you want me to get it from? At least you're working hard. So where's the income that you have? And he was like, no, I don't have any money and all that. And it was then, you know, there are some times then that you get hungry to the extent that is where your brain, everything starts functioning. I think Bansi got to that point that he was so broke. And
I've heard people to talk about something like that. They'll be like, it was at that time the idea came.
Rema,
dipped it.
Exactly.
So Akkad, I think it was at that time he went to see Akkad and said, oh God, help me now.
Thank you.
We grew up together. This us with the Osulam, but you get money past us. So what should I do? And I think that's where the thing really comes from, when you start asking questions.
Yes.
So many people are working and everything. You see 10, 20 years down the line, people don't have something to show.
Exactly.
They see hustling, living from hand to mouth. Baby girl, please, let's continue.
And that's the major thing, the issue we have in this country right now. You know, everybody keeps walking and walking like an elephant, and you're not even getting the rewards.
Exactly.
And you'll be like, what exactly am I working for? Because at the end of the day, some people don't even have savings at all. Ask them, how do you spend your salary?
There's even another thing.
I don't know.
People save to spend on frivolities. And he said something in that book. He said, if you're going to save, you say, make sure your money works for you.
Exactly.
Then when that money begs children, it's those same children will work for you again.
Yes.
Now, let us explain that. The money working from you, okay, let's say, okay, what do you do apart from talking? What do you do?
Okay, I sell
okay,
stuff.
You sell. Okay, so those stuffs you sell, let's say you make an income of, like, let's say 20,000 naira. Okay, let's say 50,000 naira. Now, from that 50,000, you can decide to save a small portion from it. Now, the small portion at the end of the year, according to what he said in the book, at the end of the year, you decide to invest it in something. I love that part where he saved the money for a whole year. Did you see what happened?
Exactly.
Oh, he gave the money to, I think, to someone who makes bricks buy jewelry for him. And that's a big lesson to learn in if you want to really get better financially. How can you give someone who makes brick money to buy jewelry? Maka.
He has nothing.
He has no sense. He does not understand what jewelry is like.
Exactly.
That one got squandered.
Exactly. And the funny thing about it is, most times when we save like that, some people they have this saving, this bad saving culture of, okay, let me live for today. Tomorrow we sort out itself. You understand? And most people even save, they don't know what they are saving for. They just save that. Okay,
Nigerians
maybe
save
for
to buy people, like I've said.
Thank you.
You save to do party.
Actually, B is out there. Let me buy. My friend is doing this thing. I must contribute. You understand? That is what we save to, like, we save to oppress others. Like, okay, I have this thing, so let me bugas more. You understand?
But that's not the way to make wealth, according to the book, Richest Man in Babylon. What's your favorite? Do you have any favorite chapter? Because me, I have one.
Well, my favorite chapter should be chapter 2.
Yes. Why?
chapter 2, because I think it was there, it was talking about the seven lessons of a lean boss and how to grow a lean boss.
Yes, so exactly.
He highlighted the seven lessons. You understand?
Should we give them the seven lessons?
If we give them, will they want to still read this book?
No. But if you've not read it, you need to read that book. The Richest Man in Babylon by Samuel Clarkson. That book is... For you to have stood the time like that, you should know it's something. And as I was reading the book, I was saying something to myself. I was like, it's like this man stays in Nigeria. He understands this problem. You know, there was a time he was talking about... he said something about you getting a house for yourself. Mm-hmm. And that's it. You realize people work in Nigeria. But at the end of the day, a larger percent goes into... You pay rent. I want to speak about you. Let me speak it. So what is someone is finished? Is exactly. Finished something?
Okay. And like he did, Akab gave us this formula, mm-hmm. right? He said, you earn for every money you earn, you pay yourself 1%, like 1/10 of mm-hmm. every money you earn. 70%. He said it should go for your housekeeping stuff, mm-hmm. the needs and all that. 20% should go for settling all the debts that you have.
So let's say you don't have debt.
Let's say you don't have debt. That means that 20%, if you like, you can add it to the 1/10 that you already saved. You understand? You can add it to it. And at the end of the year, that earning, that savings, then you invest it into something. You invest it into something that is going to bring forth more returns. So and at the end of the day, that returns, you don't eat with your 10 fingers. Mm. That's just the bottom
line. Remember
after
the first time after he saved for the whole year, mm-hmm. invested the money, mm-hmm. it got for another. Then the next year he saved.
Yes.
Then he started flexing with the money. Did you see? He said he's buying wine. He wants to enjoy life. Just flex with life.
Yes, now somebody that I've also, what do you expect? If I was the one, I would go to one Yaput now and go.
Me, I will even go to Yaput.
What are you talking? Costume did there now. You got that kind of thing. Exactly.
You just enjoy it. But then if you want the remedy for a lean horse, please, I'm still saying it all over again. Go and read that book, The Richest Man in Babylon. And it's small. There is the e-book and there is the app copy. And for you to have been written 1920. That's what it's like. That's what is amazing me.
And it's still relevant.
And it's still
in
relevant till today. It's actually a big deal. Now let me tell you about my favorite book.
Okay, I'm listening.
My favorite part is that house part. I'm serious.
What is your point of interest in that part?
Okay, the reason is because I know what rent is like. Mm. Rent takes money.
Especially in this Lagos.
Oh, my sister.
Our Lagos.
But imagine, let's say the house belongs to you, all you just have to do is just to make some maintenance once in a while. Mm-hmm. And I was talking about more space. Mm-hmm. Another thing I was able to pick that sticks with me till now is that you should be able to grow wealth little by little. Mm-hmm. And youth of nowadays are having that issue. You just want to blow once.
I think now.
It's not possible. I think it took him how many years he was explaining it.
Yes.
Like 4 or 5 years before mm-hmm. the man could trust him with some things. But people don't want to do that. Mm-hmm. People don't want to do that. Then finally, I think the one that really stuck with me more was when it was going about that 70% you spoke about when you said seven remedies for a lean boss. He said, no matter, okay, I was talking to a friend. Mm-hmm. She said, how will I be taking some small money from the small money I'm making to be saving? Mm-hmm. But I realized, Yorubas will say, oh, won't tolo. If you're spending the 100%, it will make no difference. You will still be broke.
Exactly.
So who must spend the 70%, mm-hmm. then save 1%, 10%, then use 20% to pay your debts. Mm-hmm. And please stop getting into debt. Debt is not a good thing. But then we'll go and come back. We'll go on this commercial break. When we come back, I want us to talk about, I'm sure you have some reservations about that book. Some things you didn't agree with. I didn't agree with some things.
Okay.
Okay, so let's go for this commercial break. Eunice, you've been wonderful. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Let's go for this commercial break. We'll come back and we'll talk about the things we don't agree with in the book.
Coda TV will be hosting a forum to gather great minds, people who have decided to create a niche for their businesses. Now, what is the aim of this forum? It is designed to create a way forward for small-scale businesses in Nigeria. Relax, I won't be doing the talking. We'll be inviting bankers and business professionals from different places to train you on funding approach, networking, branding, and 21st century marketing tips. This event will be holding on the 23rd of February 2019. venue to be communicated to those who have registered. Kindly note, this event is for the first 100 to register. For further inquiries, please call the number scrolling on the screen right now. Come and let's build the Nigerian brand.
Are you looking for something cool to wear? Or you need something casual to rock, be it smart and you want it customized? Then look no further, for Sludgy Olade Concepts has got you big time. Contact Sludgy Olade Concepts for your customized shirts, party wears, for your events and ceremonies, birthdays and weddings, for all your printing works. Contact or message him on 081-329-01971 or message him on Facebook at Sludgy Olade, Instagram at Sludgy Olade, Sludgy Olade Concepts. Your stop to shop for all your wares.
Okay, before we went on break, we were talking about, I was saying there's something I don't agree with. In the book, do you have any like that?
Yes, I do. I think I have just one thing.
Should we take mine first?
Let's take mine first because you own my extent. Like,
what if it's the same thing?
Oh, if it's the same thing, then that is a coincidence.
So let's take yours first.
Okay. Now, for me, I think the part I don't agree with is the part you talked about. We should try to protect our money because you're the one telling us to spread this money around, that like we should invest in something that will earn us more money. Then you come again to tell us to try as much as possible to protect your money, and I'm like wondering, is it that we just save the money and we don't use it to work to get more, or what does it actually mean? Like, it was kind of contradictory for me
from what you were saying from the beginning.
Exactly. To that point, then you now come and tell me, okay, you've been telling me save, when it gets to a certain point, invest
the money.
Understand? Then you now turn around and tell me as much as possible try and protect your money. And I'm like, protect in what sense? Maybe he was trying to his perspective about that protection of a thing. I don't get. You understand? So I think that was the major thing I didn't actually get about the whole thing.
I wish I had an answer to that. Maybe our viewers do.
No, maybe we can always call it.
We'll go and meet it.
Exactly.
Okay, but where I didn't agree with was, he was saying something about, you said fine, the investment thing and everything. But you know, the storyline is what I really had issue with. You know, he went to see his friend.
Yes.
And ask, okay, group of friends, they went together to talk about, okay, how can you help us to get this money? Okay, for those that don't understand it, there was this richest man in Babylon, his name is Akkad. His group of friends went to meet this guy. So imagine, carcass of friends, we grew up together. Then one of us, Naim, the richest man. Then how does that sound? You think people are that humble to really go and meet someone and say, can you help us with money on how life can be on this,
well,
that?
Well,
I didn't know. Maybe it should have used another storyline like that. I don't agree with that storyline particularly.
For me, I don't really blame him using that storyline because when you check around us, you see that there's a level that one gets to that you become desperate to look for solutions. You understand?
We are saying that that aspiration is what made them go.
Exactly. You can see even from Bansi, the way he was talking with his friend, you will know that he was actually desperate at that point.
Answer.
Exactly. So I think that was what drove them, because it is very rare for somebody that has been climbing a high horse to now lower himself down and say, okay, I want to learn from you. You understand? Especially when I know that we are the same carcass. You understand? So it actually took them something and a level of desperation to be able to say, okay, Akkad, come tell us, how did you make it among all of us? So I think that was what happened in that
And point. Wisdom is the principal thing. You know, you're getting, get wisdom.
Exactly.
People are always ready to give you wisdom once you ask. Pride would let people ask. I want to say a big shout out to those that design my dress. Bambi Clothiers, thank you very much for this beautiful dress. You can reach them on any platform. Yeah, it's currently right there on your screen. Call them, they deliver nationwide. Come on, they have beautiful dress. And they are not a marker.
They don't disappoint, right?
Yes. Okay, there is a giveaway, and it's two footwears. Two male footwears. You can get it for your boyfriend.
Exactly.
But you cannot get because you're on the show.
That's so sad.
Okay, we want to say a big thank you to Panda Paw Footwears. Thanks for partnering with us. They make nice footwears too. And for you to win any of these footwears, it's simple. We're going to give you a question. Who is the richest man in Babylon? You give us the answer, we give you the footwear. Simple as ABC. How do you win it? Go to all our social media platforms, like it, and make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel too. But this giveaway is particularly on Facebook. You go to our Facebook account, you'll see a picture of two of us together there. Then you answer under it. It's first come, first serve.
Exactly.
Eunice, don't go there. Eunice is second.
Don't worry.
So you tell us the name of the richest man in Babylon, and then boom, you have the shoe. You get it in our office at Secretariat, which is in Ikeja. And it's been wonderful being with us.
It's been wonderful chatting with you.
Oh, Lord. The Richest Man in Babylon is the book that we've been talking about all for like, how many minutes? I don't know. Okay, but it's been, time runs fast.
Exactly.
And we have to sign up. I can see people doing like, say, around. A big shout out to those behind the camera. You guys are wonderful. Thank you so much. Book review with Mujisara next time. Bye-bye.